दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम रविन प्रभु. ही आस्क हरे कृष्णा गुरु जी, दिस क्वेश्चन इज रिलेटेड टू यस्टरडेज डिस्कशन. इज देयर अ डायटरी प्रेस्क्रिप्शन इन भगवद गीता? थैंक यू.
Yes, Prabhu, in the 17th chapter, Krishna is talking about food, three types of food. So food in the mode of goodness increases the duration of life, purifies one's existence and gives strength, health, happiness and satisfaction. And Krishna is saying that such foods are fatty, juicy, wholesome and pleasing to the heart. So that's what in the 17th chapter, Krishna is saying that. In the 8th sloka. So foods dearer to those, there is Ayuga, Sattva, Bala, Arogyam, सुख प्रीति विवर्तन रस्याग स्निग्धाग स्थिराग हृदयाग आहाराग सात्विक प्रियाग. सो फूड डियर टू दोस इन द मोड ऑफ गुडनेस इंक्रीज द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ लाइफ प्यूरिफाई वन्स एक्जिस्टेंस एंड गिव स्ट्रेंथ हेल्थ हैप्पीनेस एंड सेटिस्फेक्शन. सच फूड्स आर जूसी फैटी होलसम एंड प्लीजिंग टू द हार्ट. व्हेन प्रभुपाद हैज ट्रांसलेटेड एज फैटी, सो वी शुड नॉट थिंक दैट फैट स्निग्धाग. सो ही हैज ट्रांसलेटेड एज फैटी, दैट डजंट मीन दैट वी द फैट वी आर एक्युमुलेटिंग. सो नॉट such kind of fat. It's the fat, it's good fat, what is needed for the body health. So that's what Prabhupada has translated. And then foods that are too bitter, too sour, salty, hot, pungent, dry and burning are dear to those in the mode of patience. Such foods cause distress, misery and disease. Tattva mila lavana ati ushna rukshnam adi ushna itikshna ruksha vidahinaka आहाराग राजसस्येष्टाग दुःख शोकामय प्रदाह. सो दैट मीन्स वी शुड नॉट बी ईटिंग एनीथिंग विच इज टू बिटर, टू साल्टी, टू कट्वा अमिल, टू एसिडिक, टू सौर. सो दैट्स व्हाट टू बिटर, टू सौर, टू साल्टी, टू हॉट, वेरी हॉट फूड. अति उष्ण, समटाइम्स पीपल वॉन्ट टू ईट वेन इट इज वेरी हॉट, सो दैट्स नॉट गुड. देन तीक्ष्ण पंजंट, देन रूक्ष ड्राई. सो तीक्ष्ण रूक्ष विदाखीनग, विदाखीनग मीन्स बर्निंग. सो सच फूड्स वी शुड नॉट बी ईटिंग. सो बिकॉज दे कॉज डिस्ट्रेस, मिसरी एंड डिजीज. सो दैट्स व्हाट कृष्णा इज सेइंग, डिस्ट्रेस, मिसरी एंड डिजीज, दुख शोकामय प्रदाग. देन यातयामं गतरसं पूति परियुषितं च यथ उच्चिष्टमपि चामेद्यं. There is bhojanam tamasa priyam. So the food which is prepared long time ago. So here yama means 3 hours. So that's why here yata yama means, that means fresh food. You eat food, prepare the food, fresh food every day and then eat it. We should not make it and put it in the fridge and the freezer and then eat it. That's not good. So we eat it every day when we offer food, fresh food we need to make it. So that's what rasam will be there. Otherwise there is no juice in it. That's why gata rasam. So there is no juice in it. Gata rasam. Yata yamam gata rasam. Puti pariyushitam chayatu. So which is bad smelling puti and which is decomposed. Pariyushitam. Puti pariyushitam. So bad smelling and decomposed. So uchistam api cha amedyam. Which is untouchable and remnants of others. Uchistam api cha amedyam means untouchable. So such foods are dearer to those in the mode of ignorance. So that way we understand these are the three types of food. So now we know the available food, which food is belongs to which category. It's not very difficult to find it out. So that's why even in the food pyramid is there. So lots of vegetables and fruits. That's why they say every day you need to eat 5 servings, 3 servings, some servings of fruits and vegetables and all such things we need to eat. So definitely meat and all is not coming into picture. It's not hridayaga. It is not pleasing to the heart. So like that, if we follow this and then just offer to Krishna, so we will be able to follow the diet restrictions. Hare Krishna Prabhu, I hope you understand. Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Guruji. I understood that clearly. I have another question, if you don't mind, on chapter 12 that we are discussing. Yes, so up to the shlokas that we learned, what I understood is that what Krishna is saying is fix your mind on to me without deviation. And then he's saying, if you cannot do that, follow regulative principles of bhakti yoga. And if you cannot do that, try to work for me. And if you cannot do that, try to give me all the fruits of the activities. And if you can't do that, cultivate knowledge. So my question is, when I look at all these things, they are all the same thing. What is the difference between each of them? We have understood that if this is not there, this, we should do this, this, this. But when I'm looking at them, all of them as together, they are all the same thing. So what are the difference between them? If you can elaborate a little bit.
When you started from the 8th sloka, when Krishna is saying that, you fully fix your mind and intelligence on me. Are we able to do that now in our day-to-day life? If we say that, if you ask the question, how many hours we are able to fix our mind and intelligence on Krishna? If we just ask a question. It's very hard to answer, right? We are not, we are so much busy when we forget Krishna easily, when we are interacting with others. Are we able to 24/7 fix our mind and intelligence on Krishna? It's
no.
The answer is no, right? So that means we are not satisfying that first verse, that 8th verse, the first option we are not able to satisfy, correct?
Yeah.
So that's a different thing. So then Krishna is saying that if you are not able to do that, then practice doing that. Every day chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. So sit and do that, practice doing that. So are we also able to do that or not? That's another question comes. Are we able to practice? So if you are able to practice every day, and then that way 16 rounds when we are chanting, 16 rounds, our mind should be completely under our control. It should not go anywhere else. If that happens, then the remaining time also, our mind will be under our control only. Slowly, slowly, it will become like that. So are we able to completely do that? No. So we need to do that practice. So all these things we need to continue doing. So it's not that the way you are saying same thing means, in that sense, if you say it is fine. But in terms of doing, in terms of activity, they are all different things. So then, so if you are not, yes, Prabhu.
Sorry to interrupt you. So before going to the third one, so these two, fix your mind onto me and follow the regulative principles of Bhakti Yoga, which is Hare Krishna, Hare Rama mantra. So aren't they the same thing? Because if I'm able to do Hare Krishna, Hare Rama mantra for 24 hours. Then
in the translation, it is given like that. Probably you understand that way. But in the real meaning of the 8th sloka, Krishna is not talking about that. Fix your mind upon me means always focus. That is, literally, if you talk about the, in English words, fully remember Krishna completely 24/7, fix your mind on Krishna. Whether we are able to do that or not, that is the question here. So even if you are doing a Hare Krishna Mahamantra, that comes in the practice. So the chanting comes in the Abhyasa. Abhyasa means it's the practice. So that's what in the next one, Prabhu. These two are not same. Whether we are able to fix or not, already we answered the question, it is not, correct? So then you are practicing it. So when you are chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, you are doing the second thing. You are practicing it. And once you fix also, you are chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, but at that time, you are not practicing it. You have already achieved the success. That is the way you are fixing your mind on Krishna. So there is a difference between the two, correct, Prabhu? So yeah, already you achieved or not? That is the question here. Already you are able to focus your mind and intelligence on Krishna. It doesn't mean that once you practice, once you chant, and once you achieve that, then you stop chanting. It is not like that. You will continue to do that, correct?
Yes. So yeah, there's a very fine, I think.
Yeah, yeah. But in terms of the understanding the sloka, it is very clear. So fully 24/7, this means I'm talking about 24/7, Prabhu. I'm not talking about, Krishna is not talking about Sastasmat, Sarvesu, Kalesu, Mamanasmara, Dudhicha, Mayarpita, Mano, Buddhir, Mame, Vesis. It's not talking about only 16 rounds. It is 24/7. Are we able to do? That's the question.
So how about remembering Krishna during the sleep?
No, sleep is the point. When you go to sleep, you are, before sleeping, you can remember Krishna. So if you get consciousness, you can remember Krishna. But sleep is the time you are completely taking rest. So that is a different thing. So that's why during the daytime, if you are able to remember Krishna all the time, during the sleep also, you won't be affected much. So you will be able to be in Krishna consciousness. See, from the mind, all these material thoughts should be completely gone from. That is the problem. This garbage is sitting in our mind, so that's what is creating all problems. So we need to slowly, slowly clear them out. We need to clean our mind. Clean, that's a very important thing. So once our mind is perfectly 100% is pure and clean, so it is going to only remember Krishna. It's not going to think or worry about anything in this material world. You get that point, Prabhu?
Okay, Prabhu, yeah, understood. Guruji, one more question. So what is the chapter where this shloka is there, which says to spread the knowledge and then you will come to me, you are dear to me?
18th chapter, shloka number around 67, 68, so around that it comes from. So the last, after giving the entire Bhagavad Gita class, so Krishna is asking Arjuna that. So yeah, in the 68th shloka, exactly. या इदं परमं कुख्यं मद्भक्ते स्वविदासरि भक्तिमयि परां कृत्वा मामेवेसि असंसे. सो फॉर वन हु एक्सप्लेन्स दिस सुप्रीम सीक्रेट टू द डिवोटीज, प्योर डिवोशनल सर्विस इज गारंटीड एंड एट द एंड ही विल कम बैक टू मी. सो देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट. सो दैट्स द मेन थिंग. सो मामेवेसि असंसे मींस एट द एंड ही विल कम बैक टू मी, देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट. सो दैट्स व्हाट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट.
Thank
and
you.
The next Krishna is saying that if he, anyone who is doing this, no one else can become dearer to me than one who gives this knowledge to others. Nacha tasman manushesu kaschin me priya kritamaga bhavita nacha me tasman anyega priyataro bhavi. Not only in this life, even in future also, nobody else can become dearer to me than the person who gives this knowledge to others. So that's why every day I'm emphasizing on that, that this is our important service. We need to do it. We need to figure it out. We need to maybe online some advertisement, something like Timir Prabhu has done so much, and that's why we all identified. So now we need to come up with even more ideas as a team. We need to brainstorm. We need to do, because there are many, many, many devotees. They don't know that we are studying Bhagavad Gita. If they know, they will also join. We all come to know. They came to know. That's why you are here. But many devotees, they don't know. So how we are going to let them know? That's the question here. That part, if we do, that is fine. You get it, Prabhu? You understand that?
Yes, Prabhu. Very well explained. I have a last question, if you don't mind. We always mention in this class that fix your mind and intelligence on me. So I understand how to fix, how to try to fix mind onto Krishna, but how to try to fix intelligence onto Krishna? If you can give
intelligence in the 10th chapter, 10th sloka, Krishna is saying that. तेषां सतत युक्तानां भजतां प्रीतिपूर्वकं ददामि बुद्धि योगं तं येन माम उपयान्ति. Those who are always तेषां सतत युक्तानां, always engaged in worshipping me with love, with devotion. भजतां प्रीतिपूर्वकं, प्रीति means love. With love and devotion, those who worship me, I give them the intelligence by which they will come to me. That's what Krishna is saying. So if you are not connected with this material world, if our mind is not thinking about this material world, then our intelligence is very well established. That's why in the second chapter, Krishna is saying that prasade sarva dukkhanam hanirasyopajayate prasanna chetasoha asu buddhir pariyavatisthati. Our intelligence is very well established. If we are able to study this Bhagavad Gita and get this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita and practice chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra and control our mind and then control our senses. So all these things at that point of time, our intelligence is very well established. Otherwise, if you are not yukta, if you are ayukta, means nasti buddhi ayuktasya. So ayuktasya means if you are not engaged in Krishna's service, if you don't have the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we don't have intelligence. We'll lose our intelligence. Nasti buddhi ayuktasya. So whenever we are connected with remembering the material sense objects, we are going to lose intelligence. Whenever we remember Krishna, we need to gain intelligence. That's what we need to understand.
Okay, very well explained. Thank you, Guruji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu. Hare
Krishna. Thank you, Guruji. So that way, can we say that when we are doing Abhyasa, when we are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, Maha mantra, we are trying to remember Krishna. But since we are in the practice phase, so sometimes we will remember Krishna and sometimes we will, the mind will go here and there. But once a person after practicing, once he achieves perfection, then he will be able to remember Krishna, like fix his mind on Krishna all the time. So that way, like all these two words, they are similar, but they are not exactly the same because they are like two different steps. Like one is a lower step and one is a higher step. Can we say like that, Guruji? I mean the verse number, this verse number 8 and verse number 9 of the 12th chapter.
Krishna is giving the first preference. See, you are given four choices. So Krishna, if you ask Krishna which one you want to do, Krishna is asking us to 24/7, fix your mind and intelligence on him. That is the first preference. If you are not able to do, then do this. If you are not able to do this, then do this. That's what Krishna is saying in each and every shloka.
Okay.
So definitely the other. But if you are not able to do, then do this. That's what Krishna is saying.
Right, right. Yeah. So that way, like if Krishna gives like four, let us say preference. So it means if yes, somebody
what
is not.
Is going to happen, Prabhu, what is going to happen if we at least start doing this? Then we will slowly evolve and come to the first one, Prabhu. That's what is going to happen. It is not
yes,
that
yes, good, yeah.
We stop it. We will evolve and then we will come to the topmost one and we will be able to fix our mind and intelligence and Krishna. We will not stop with one thing alone. So Krishna is giving, this is the topmost. If you are not able to be here, then start from the bottommost and then come back, come up. That's it.
Yes, Guruji. Yeah, that exactly was my question. Like if we cannot do that, then we can start from the fourth one and then after some time, we'll be able to do both the third and the fourth and then like second, third and fourth and finally all the four. Okay. Thank you, Guruji. Thank you.